Lindsay from Rented Space, and thank you for joining me again today. So today I am going to be pruning my tomato bushes back. I want to take off the bottom foliage, and I'm actually going to try and I'm going to pot it up and try and grow some more tomatoes with it. So double my plants. And also I've noticed that I'm starting to get some flowers already, but I don't really think my tomato plants are big enough to be able to do that, so I may also take some of those flowers off. So join me in my thing today. Let's go. I'm just going to move you down so you can see. So basically, I don't know if you can really see, let's see. So as you can see, it's quite full in here. So just cut off these little bits, these bottom branches. Now I've been a bit slack and I haven't actually staked them yet either, so get the stakes and do that also while I am here. I'm just going to get my basket. So that one should be okay. I might just get rid of that one too. This one at the back here is. Go and push up the lip here. Alright, so that's that done. Now I will get some stakes in there. Okay, so didn't mean to take you out there. So I'm just going to put some stakes in around. Now these stakes are from the actual bamboo grown on the property. I definitely think I'm going to need to cut some more bamboo down and get some more stakes this year. There we go. And I'll just move you over here. so that is them trimmed back. I may still trim them back a little bit more, but now I have a basket. I have a nice little basket here now of cuttings, which I'm going to pot up into some other pots, and then we will be able to grow some more tomatoes. Now that I have my basket of tomato cuttings, I'm going to pinch off the bottom leaves, and that'll go in the compost, and I will plant them up. Some pots that I've already used. Pull my pots out. So they're about half an inch or so from the top. Maybe. You can fill them to the top, it's not a big deal. So I'm just going to fill them up, and then once I've done it, I'll put the plant in. And then I'll water them all. So that's looking a little bit sad, because, but once I water it, and that it'll pick up. Now, in case you didn't realize, the reason I'm doing this is, so all along, a bit hard to see, but tomatoes have like those hairs. Well, each of those hairs will turn into a root. So by cutting it, and the more of it I put in to soil, the more root base basically the plant has.
So I'm just filling all the pots here and ensuring the soil is in without compacting it in too much. Now also, like I said, the best thing with tomatoes is that every hair will become a root. So you can actually get a really strong plant simply by burying the stem extra deep in the soil when you're repotting it or planting it up, or in this case, using cuttings and offcuts to create new plants.
It's funny, years ago I used to think that tomatoes were hard to grow. Now I remember I was speaking to a local man. I used to grow them and I used to buy his seedlings from out front of his house. And he said to me one day, he goes, "You buy so many." And I said, "Well, yeah, I've got three kids who eat them like apples." And he said, "Well, why don't you grow them from seed?" And I was like, "Oh, no, it's too hard, I can't do that." And I said, "Tomatoes are really hard to grow." And he goes, no, they're not. And then he showed me about the roots and how easy they can be. And it's funny, isn't it, how you don't realise these things until someone tells you. But we always think that we can't do things. We don't realise often what our abilities are. We don't trust in our abilities. I mean, really, we should. I mean, I'm no expert. But I mean, if I can do this, I think anyone can do it. Now, because I'm not growing these from seeds, I'm just using a herb and vegetable specialty mix. So repotting mix, not like a seed raising. Because obviously they've been thin, but it's still pretty, like there's not lots of bark and stuff in it, but it's pretty broken down. Not exactly. I'm quite messy when I do this, but that's why I have the cardboard down. You catch it a bit dry, doesn't it? And I can pick it up and feed into another pot. Then I'm not losing so much of it. Okay, so Now, this is a great money save, especially too if you are having issues or, you know, you don't want to try and grow from seed because you don't think you have, or if it's too late and you've missed your opportunity. Go to, you know, Bunnings or your local farmer's market and buy your seedlings. And then just trim them like I did. And then use your cuttings and repot them up. And you can, you know, quadruple your plants. And it means that each plant then doesn't cost as much. So I think I did actually buy these tomatoes plants. So I bought the three, and I think they were, I think it worked out as $11 or $12 for the three of them. So, you know, that's realistically not cheap. But then once I get my plants and then I do this, well, it goes from, say, $12 for three plants to $12. Well, what have I got now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So instead of them being, you know, $4 each, it's now come down to, you know, what did I say, 23, I think I said. So realistically, it's like 50 cents a plant now. So, you know, when you can go from $4 a plant and then you take off your cuttings when they get a bit bigger, and then all of a sudden you end up with, you know, instead of three plants, we'll say 24, $12 comes up to like $3-$4 a plant, comes down to 50 cents a plant, which means you get a lot more tomatoes for a lot less money. And the things that would have ended up in the compost bin, because you've cut them off, pruned them, you've now turned into food. So now just a bit of a watering. Now the water, obviously they need to be watered in. You can tell they're a bit droopy because obviously they haven't had water. But it will also help to push the dirt down. Now, I normally wouldn't wet the leaves, but I've got a lot of dirt on there, so I'm trying to get the dirt off of them.
Here and watch this, I realise just how much in desperate need I am of actually having a potting bench. If I was doing this at a potting bench, I wouldn't have the issue of sitting on the ground and dirt going everywhere. I would have a lot cleaner spot to be able to do this. And my videos would probably actually look a lot better because you'd be able to see what was going on. But anyway, as I finish washing the dirt off of the plants and watering them in, I'm quite happy with the amount of extra plants I've got.
Give them really good watering in. I've watered them in quickly now, but I will come back and do some more, give them another drink later. Well, that one pushed in a bit too far, I think. Okay. Anyway, so, and we'll come and check them out again later. But I will give you an update later down the road as well.